Good afternoon, students. I am Dr. Shujay Sarkar of your college, Department of Zoology. Today I am describe about the theory portion on environmental pollution. It is a very vast topic in UE5 in your theory portion. There are several questions from this chapter. Okay, just see what going to present. First of all, we know that what is environmental pollution. Pollution is a necessary civil of all development. Due to lack of development of a culture of pollution control, there has resulted a heavy backlog of gaseous, liquid, and the solid pollution in our country. It is to be claimed, thus pollution control in our country is a rare recent environmental concern. Not only in India, but in developed Western world also. Pollution is a scare word. Pollution is a man-made problem mainly of developed countries. The developed countries have been in a mad race to exploit every bit of natural resources, to convert them into goods for their comfort, and to export them to needy developing world. In doing so, the industrialized countries dump lot of material in the environment, which becomes polluted. In one way, pollution has been, in fact, exported to developing countries. So students, what is pollution? Pollution is an undesirable change in the physical, chemical, or biological characteristics of air, water, and soil that may harmfully affect the life or create a potential health hazard of any living organism. Pollution is the direct or indirect change in any component of the biosphere that is harmful to the living components and in particular undesirable for human beings, affecting adversely the industrial progress, cultural and natural assets, or general environment. So, it is a definition of the pollution. And what is pollutant? Any substance which causes pollution is called a pollutant. A pollutant may thus include any chemical or geochemical like dust, sediment, grit, etc. Substance, biotic component or its product, or physical factor like heat that is released intentionally by man into the environment in such concentration that may have adverse, harmful, or unpleasant effects. A pollutant has also been defined as any solid, liquid, or gaseous substance present in such concentration as may be or tend to be injurious to the environment. Pollutants are the residue of things we make, use, and throw away. There are many sources of such pollutants, that the lakes and the rivers are polluted by the waste from chemical and other factories, and the air by gases of automobile exhaust, industry, and thermal power plant. So, this is all about your environmental pollution and the pollutant. So, what is the behind? It is as a question, the definition and the pollutant definition. In the next slide, pollutant can be classified into two types, non-degradable and non-degradable. Non-degradable can be divided into waste and the poison, and the degradable is divided into rapidly degradable and slow degradable. On the basis of the existence in nature, the pollutant is a quantity pollutant. It means the substance which are already present in the environment but are termed as pollutants as their concentration quantity increases in the environment. Like, as an example, carbon dioxide is present in the environment in greater quantity than normal and is hence termed as a quantity pollutant. and what is qualitative pollutants, the substances which are not normally present in the environment and are added by human beings and are pollutants by nature, like insecticides, pesticides. Okay, in the next slide I will describe on the basis of the form in which they persist. According to, it is the primary pollutants, means the substances which are directly emitted from the source and remain in that form are termed as the primary pollutants, like smoke, fumes, ash, dust, nitric oxide and sulfur dioxide. And the secondary pollutants, the substances which are formed by chemical reaction between the primary pollutant and the constituents of the environment, like those which are already present in the environment, like smoke, ozone, sulfur trioxide, nitrogen dioxide, etc. So environmental pollutants are some deposited matter like soot, smoke, tar and dust, grit, I say in the previous slide, and the like gases like oxides of nitrogen, NO, NO2, and the sulfur, SO2, carbon monoxide, CO, halogens like chlorine, bromine, iodine. And like acid droplets, it is sulfuric acid and nitric acid. And some fluorides are also present. Some metals like mercury, lead, iron, zinc, nickel, tin, cadmium, chromium. Agrochemicals like biocides, pesticides, herbicides, fungicides, nematicides, bactericides, weedicides, and fertilizers. Complex organic substances like benzene, ethyl, acetic acid, benzpyrenes, benzopyrenes, etc. Photochemical oxidants like photochemical smog, ozone peroxyacetyl nitrate, PAN, peroxybenzoyl nitrate, PBN, PBZN, and nitrogen oxide, aldehyde, ethyl, ethylene, like solid waste and the radioactive waste and noise are as an environmental pollutant. So it is there has grown up serious concern all over the world about the rivers turning murky, fish rotting on seashore, tree withering, cities choking with foul air, toxic chemicals being cycled into foodstuff, and disease epidemics appearing so frequently. So modern man must re-establish an unbroken link with nature and with life. He must again learn to invoke the energy for doing things and to recognize as did the ancients in India centuries ago, that one can take from the earth and the atmosphere only so much as one put back into them. So types of air pollution is air pollution, water pollution, noise pollution, littering, spilling of oils and in oceans, soil contamination by lead and heavy metals, radioactive contamination, thermal pollution, and the visual pollution. These are the types of pollution. So first of all, we discuss about the pollution, then we discuss about the pollutant. After that, there is a brief introduction in past. There are different types of pollution are there. Next, we just go through your next topic. This is called the air pollution. Okay. Air pollution. So what is air pollution? Excessive discharge of undesirable foreign substance into atmospheric air, thereby adversely affecting the quality of air and causing damage of human to human plants and animal life. This is called the air pollution. This is the basic definition of air pollution. So what are the major air pollutants? The particulates like dust, smoke, fly ash, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, ammonia, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxide, hydrogen cyanide, hydrogen sulfide, hydrogen fluoride, chlorine, phosgene, asbestos, aldehydes, radiation, and the hydrocarbons. These are the major air pollutants. The classification air pollutants, that there are two types of classification. One type of classification is the primary air pollutants and the secondary air pollutants. In primary, the poisonous gases and undesirable chemicals which cause air pollution is called a primary air pollutant. And secondary air pollution is derived from the primary air pollution. So what is this is derived from the primary air pollution is called the secondary air pollution. The carbon particles from unburned fuel, ammonia, sulfur dioxide, hydrocarbon, oxides of nitrogen, oxides of carbon, and lead are known as the primary air pollutant. And in bright sunlight, the nitrogen, nitrogen oxides, oxygen, and the hydrocarbons, photochemical reaction, powerful oxidants, ozone, aldehydes, sulfuric acid, peroxyacetal nitrate, means PAN, peroxidase, and they form the photochemical smog. They form photochemical smog. Okay. So these are the two types of pollutants. One is primary air pollutant, second is secondary air pollutant. So primary air pollutant means the poisonous gases, the undesirable chemicals which cause air pollution. And the secondary air pollutant means from the primary air pollutant, these are derived. These are called secondary air pollutants. Sources of air pollution. There are two sources, mainly natural and man-made. Natural means natural contaminants like fungi, spores, yeast, bacteria, methane, dust, etc. Carbon monoxide form, methane gas, volcanic eruption, forest fire, electrical storms, and solar fires, salt spray from ocean, and dust storm. These are the natural air pollution. And man-made, rapid industrialization, automobile revolution, and the deforestation is called the sources of the air pollution. Next, classification of the pollutants. There are the gases and the particulates. In gases, there are oxides of sulfur, oxides of nitrogen, oxides of carbon, carbon dioxide, ozone, hydrogen sulfide, chlorofluorocarbons, hydrogen fluoride, hydrocarbons, photochemical oxidants, and the aerosols. And in particulates, there are present dust, smoke, fog, smog. The smog can be divided into two types, London smog and the Los Angeles smog, fly ash, soot, fumes, and the natural particulates. These are the particulates of the classification of the pollutants. These are the picture, one picture, how the pollutants are there. There is some man-made pollution, the natural pollution, the secondary pollution from primary pollution. Okay. These are the diagram really show. The major pollutants, sources and effects, like carbon monoxide, the first major pollutant. It is a colorless, odorless and tasteless gas. No effect at the normal concentration is present in the 0.1 ppm, so it is not effect. But higher concentration seriously affects. Volcanoes, natural gas emissions, seed germination contribute to carbon monoxide. Transport sector contributes 75% carbon monoxide. Residential wood burning 10%, industrial boxes 15%. These are the pie chart. There are carbon monoxide transmission. The transportation from transportation 75.7%, residential wood burning 10.6%, other sources 0.2, aluminium smelters 9.1, pulp and paper 2%, and other industry 2.4%. So total all over 100% can be divided into this portion. So maximum 75.7% account from the automobiles. Then the effects. So what are the effects of the carbon monoxide? It can reduce oxygen carrying capacity of blood because it has affinity to bound with the hemoglobin. Then the decrease in vision and the causes cardiovascular disorders. This is the effect, major effect of the present of this type of gases in our air. The carbon dioxide, fuel combustion, jet plane use O2 and the release of CO2 and burning. Effects, it can cause headache and the nausea. Effect on the climate, increase and global temperature. In the oxides of nitrogen, there are NO, NO2 and the NTU. And the fuel combustion in automobiles industry, lightning, forest fires, natural ionizing radiation. Effect, it can reduce blood carrying capacity and cause the lung problems. Oxides of sulfur, it is released from the volcanic eruption. It is generally called SOx, including SO2 or SO3. 67% is like pollution from volcanic activities and other natural resources, remaining due to fossil fuel burning, transportation, and the industrial activity. It can problem our health that the respiratory problems, marbles, cloth, paper, leather also be affected from this portion, and the plants are also heavily affected. Then the hydrocarbons. These include methane, ethylene, acetylene, and the terpenes. Sources include coal fields, natural fires, incomplete combustion, forest fire, agriculture fire. It is an carcinogenic effect. It can form ozone and PM, which are harmful, damage plants, rubber materials, and the fabric and the paint. In the next slide, the particulate matters. Particulates of different substances suspended in the air. In the form of solid particles and liquid droplets. Particles vary widely in size. Different particles materials are aerosols, dust, smoke, fumes, mist, fog, fly ash, etc. Fine particles come from a variety of sources: diesel trucks and the buses, construction equipment, power plants, wood stove, wildfires. Also, chemical reaction in the atmosphere can transform gases into fine particles. So, what are the effects? It is the cause. What are the effects? It can irritate respiratory tract, irritate eyes, nose, and throat. Lead particles cause lead poisoning. Lead particles cause lead poisoning. Cadmium particles, cardiovascular disease, kidney and liver damage. Nickel particles, respiratory damage. Mercury. Central nervous effect on the central nervous system and kidney and brain. Radioactive substance affect future generation. These are the effect on the human being for the air pollution. On animals, it can also be very harmful. Feeding particulate coated plants like chlorine, lead, arsenic poisoning, and lead poisoning, bronchitis, lack of appetite, and in pet animals. On implants, it's spraying pesticides, organic manure, and the agriculture application affect growth of plants, destroy chlorophyll formation, disturb photosynthesis, SO2 decreases chlorophyll content, causes fluorosis, NO2 permanent leaf fall, ozone necrosis, dead area on leaf damages and leaves, damages the leaves. So what are the effect? On materials, it can corrosion, it can abrasion, it can deposition. Chemical attack on the surface. On climate, it can affect on the climate. It increases in carbon dioxide, increased temperature of atmosphere, like global warming, like greenhouse gases are there. I will come in the greenhouse gases after a few slides. Ice and the polar glaciers melt, folding coastal towns, change rainfall pattern, agriculture output change. Depletion of the ozone layer increases presentation, increased penetration of harmful UV rays on earth, skin disease, sunburn, inactivation of RNA, DNA, and the protein molecules. So how can we control, how can we stop the air pollution? It cannot be stopped. It cannot be fully prevented, but can be controlled in our country. Preventive measures are there, control measures using equipment. So preventive measures like selection of suitable fuel, low sulfur coal in power plant using CNG, modification industrial process, selection of suitable site and zoning for industrial unit. When sources control not possible, some measures can prevent pollution, collecting pollutants by using equipment, destroying all the pollutants by thermal catalytic combustion, changing the pollutants to less toxic form, by releasing of the pollutants through tall chimneys and for greater dispersion. Prevention by law or something. Various laws has been established in the means of air pollution. So first of all, law is Act of 1981. After the Prevention Control Amendment is 1987. Motor Vehicle Act in 1988 and the Air Union Territories Rule 1983 and Environment Protection Act 1986. They are the laws to protect our environment. and government trying to remove the use of the leaded petrol, a major cause of air pollution. The industrial acts are implemented to control the harmful emission of gases. The natural management team was minimize the effect of various natural disasters like forest fire, volcanic eruption that are caused through air pollution. So this is one type of from image from our newspaper. This is a late Kolkata bridge. In Kolkata, and the quality of index, it is an air quality index, it is called the AIQ, air quality, sorry, AQI, air quality index. If the particulate matter count 0 to 100, 0 to 50, it's a good quality of air. It's 51 to 100, it is satisfactory, minor breathing discomfort and sensitive people. Then moderately polluted, 101 to 200, breathing discomfort for people with asthma and heart disease. Poor, 201 to 300, is prolonged exposure and discomfort for people with heart disease. Very poor, 310, 310 to 400 respiratory illness are there and might affect people with lung and heart disease. 401 to 450, it means the respiratory impact, even on the healthy people, serious health impact with lung, heart disease, might feel exhausted even during light physical activity. So these are the paper cutting using the pollution in India and other countries. So Delhi was the most polluted city. India slips to 155 among 178 countries environmental performance index. And 92% of world pollution gets polluted here. It's called the World Health Organization according to World. And the crop fires had 70% share in Delhi peak air pollution. So this is due to the pollution. Our country is in the number one or two after the Bangladesh. We are the second position in 2020. In the 2020, India slips rank after the Bangladesh. Bangladesh is 139, India is 123, India is 123. What is greenhouse gas? Greenhouse gas is in any gas that accumulates lower energy, infrared radiation. These gases consume water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, troposphere ozone, and the nitrous oxide. The greenhouse effect is the process by which greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide are invisible to visible light, littering sunlight pass through our atmosphere and warm the earth. Then, however, greenhouse gases act like a blanket, trapping some earth hot as it escapes back out of the space. Then burning fossil fuels and extra greenhouse gases to the atmosphere. It cannot be released from the atmosphere. So these extra gases trap more heat, causing the warm the climate, our troposphere, our air, nearby air, and it is not controlled. So effects on the sea level. What are the effects? Rising temperature cause water of the ocean along with the sea to increase. Increasing temperature melt ice to start flow into seas at Antarctic and the Greenland. Sea levels rise 20 to 40 centimeters, causing floods in floods on areas with low cost areas like Bangladesh and Netherlands. Flood in many areas cause a danger for living things. The global warming can be effect alter the rainfall pattern. Some people are they are showing that the rainfall pattern is changed. Rainfall pattern is changed. So effects on farming changes in the weather affect the growing crops around the world. Crops of wheat, rice grow well in high temperature. Sugarcane and the maize do not survive high temperature and end up dying. Furthermore, change in the amount of rainfall affects the growth, leading to a shortage of food. Certain and southwestern part of the world will be affected as people will suffer without food. So, there is a climate change and the food security. At present, 23% world geographical area is affected by the degradation. India faces the problem in nearly 30% of its land due to multiple reasons, including the deforestation. Effects on the people and the animals. Changes make it hard for humans to adjust and adapt to climate. Avoiding all the disasters moving from one place to another will be hard. Well, weather and temperature and changes, the homes of plants and animals will be affected. Moving ocean animals like seals will be hurt. Now, new homes for animals may not be safe, causing loss of animal population. So these are the, they are the newspaper cutting another one. The Arctic ice are melting. Record slow and shrinking, it sinks. So the polar bear cannot persist here. The consequence of global warming, glacier and the sea levels increasing, Arctic summer can be used to ice free 2040 by 2040, and the sea levels could rise as much 23%, 23 inches by 2100 at current warming patterns continue. If we follow this pattern, so 2001, there are 23 inches our land is rise. So sorry, water is rise. The consequence of global warming on wildlife, rising temperature of revenge coral reefs and melt the habitats, polar bears and the Antarctic penguins, ecosystem shift and species die off. And the global warming on health, hotter weather enables deadly mosquito to travel greater distance. Carbon dioxide in the air aggravates the asthma and the allergy. Then the consequence of global warming weather pattern. High temperature could lead to increased droughts and wildfires, heavier rainfall and a greater number of category 4 to 5 hurricanes, means strong. So how to prevent the greenhouse effect? This is a man-made wasteful buying. If you don't need to truly want something, do not buy it. It is going to end up in the garbage. Turn off the light when you leave the room. Don't leave your television on while you go to sleep. Only turn on the water when you need it. For example, turn off turn it off while you are putting toothpaste on the toothbrush. Turn it back on when you need it. The reduce, reuse, and the recycle. The key term, reduce the things that you need, reuse items that you have until they are no longer any good, and recycle all that is possible in certain areas, not recycling, and it's starting to become illegal. So there are three things: reuse, reduce, and the recycle. Then choose natural gases over coal and the oil every chance you get. For example, when barbecuing, get a hybrid on electric car, get a hybrid or an electric car when shopping for that new car. It's not possible, choose a small car that gets good gas mileage. Form an environmental club in your high school, college, or community. Walk to places, forget there by bike. It will improve your health and the health of your planet. Get involved in tree planting project. So they are the citations from where I get this making the PPT. And the next chapter is a photochemical smog. It is also major effects of the air pollution. So photochemical smog, what is photochemical smog? Is an air pollution formed when photons of sunlight hit molecules in different kinds of pollutants in the atmosphere. Different kinds of pollution in the atmosphere. This is a nitrogen dioxide, volcanic organic compound. It is called a VOC, and the peroxyacetyl nitrate, PAN, is produced by photochemical smog. So this is a reaction. First of all, nitrogen oxide is reacting with a VOC. Okay, then it is produced NO2, nitrogen dioxide. Then NO2 plus UV, it forms the NO plus O, nitric oxide in atomic oxygen, then atomic oxygen plus oxygen is called oxygen, ozone O3, then NO2 plus VO, PAN is produced PAN, etc. And net result NO plus NOC, O2, and plus UV, it can be formed O3, PAN, and the other oxygen. The nitrogen oxide driven photochemical smog effect on the photochemical smog. It can mostly comes from the smoke of the vehicles, trucks, and contact of this sunlight result in the smoke formation. The volatile organic compound like VOC are emitted as the gases from certain solids or liquids. VOCs include a variety of chemicals, some of which may be have short, long-term, and adverse health effects. VOCs are emitted by a wide array of products numbering by the in the thousands. The paints, pesticides, and the building materials and the furnishings, glue, and the adhesive are the example of the volatile organic compound or VOC. Then the photochemical peroxide nitrate designation PAN are the secondary pollutants, which means that they are not directly emitted as exhaust from the power plant in internal combustion engines, but they are formed from their from other pollutants by chemical reaction and in this atmosphere. These are the effects of smog in our body. There's a burning of eyes, throat irritated, mucous membrane problem with the mucous membrane, and the shortness of breath, wheezing, and the coughing, asthma attacks, chest pain. These are the respiratory diseases are the form. How ozone is formed? Ozone is in the atmosphere present, oxygen present in the atmosphere, nitric oxide present. Byproduct of combustion and it, sunlight, when it is act on the sunlight, it is from the ozone. It is from the ozone. Ozone formed by three oxygen molecules. So what are the prevention measures? Preventive measures. Try to use vehicles at minimum level and check the engine smoke emission frequently. Prevent high uses of coals, which result in heavy smog, reduction of fumes from metal working and other industrial plants. By green electricity produced by low or even zero pollution. Reduce pesticides. Then the consumers can reduce volatile oxygen. There's a VOC. VOC means the volatile organic compound. Volatile organic compound emissions by avoiding paints with labels that clearly indicate VOC. VOC limits are high. Switching to water test paint is also used. The great smog is occurred during 1952. It's a big smog. 4,000 had died permanently and 1 lakh more were made ill because of the smoke effect. It is produced in the London in December 1952. So let's start living and stop existing and save our Mother Earth. In the last one topic, acid rain. So what is acid rain? Acid rain is basically rain that has a higher than normal acid level. It can have harmful effects on plants, aquatic animals, and the infrastructure. Sources of acid rain is acid rain broad, referring as a mixture of wet and dry deposition from the atmosphere containing higher than normal amount of nitric and the sulfuric acid. The sources is the two nitrogen oxides, the VOC, then the and this is according to these sources. Then the gaseous pollutants in the atmosphere, the pollutants and the particulate pollutants in the atmosphere, and when they mix and the pollution in cloud water and the precipitate as a wet deposition, as a rain. Next, a wet deposition, it refers to acidic rain, fog, and the snow. If the acid chemicals in the air are blown into areas where the weather is wet, the acid can fall to form rain, snow, fog, or mist. As this water flow over the through the ground, it can affect variety of plants and animals. Dry deposition, in area where the weather is dry, acid chemicals may become incorporated into dust or smoke and fall into ground through a dry deposition. Taking the ground, buildings, homes, cars, and the trees. The effects can be divided in three parts: on non-living, one living, and one soil. So in Taj Mahal in our India, Delhi, present in the Agra, suffering from the sulfur dioxide, sulfuric acid, and other fumes of pollutants released from the Mathura refinery. An acid rain caused extensive damage to buildings, statues, bridges, and structural material or marble line or stone. Effect on living: the sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxide gases can cause respiratory diseases like asthma, chronic bronchitis. Tiny particles cause difficulty in breathing to humans and animals, and also lead to permanent lung damage. Effect on the water element: it can cause the acidity of lakes, rivers, which is directly affect aquatic. And the trees and soil, acid can dissolve all the nutrient and useful minerals for the tree to grow, weakens the process of photosynthesis. According to modern researcher, acid leaches potassium, calcium, magnesium, etc., essential element from the top of soil. When soil is contaminated, the cereal production from crops. Acids activate the aluminium from the soil, which leads into water and fish die. Drinking water is contaminated. The measurement control for preventive measures fits scrubbers and the factory chimneys with the chemical filters and remove impurities such as sulfur from smoke. Cars can be fitted with special converters which remove dangerous chemicals, reduce the amount of electricity we use, turn TVs off of the mains, don't leave on standby, turn off lights when the room is not in use, limit the number of vehicles on the roads, and increase public transport. So these are the native species may be wiped out by the acid rain, and some native species or original tree plant species are wiped out due to the acid rain. And the acid rain environmental crisis study concerns. These are the all about your air pollution. If any questions arise in your mind, you can free to ask to me and write on the comment box. Okay, thank you all for your